as humans all. It took us a family, farm, or peasant who had a world is near. Behold the glory of the Empire, Julius Caesar driving his mighty horses through battlefields and hunting grounds, down into the valley and up into the hills. Ancestors of the Frisian horse were in great demand for such regal performances of strength and endurance. Running an empire comes with a high cost, however, and this meant taxes and, oh no, tax collectors. Roman soldiers marched through the entire empire and often forcefully collected tax money or demanded hides or other kinds of goods. Charging these high taxes starting to show, however, some issues, especially on the fringes of the empire, where they did not want to pay them anymore. The Roman Empire slowly lost its authority to people groups such as the Frisian people and others in the Low Countries who did not want to pay these tax increases that they were experiencing. They wanted their independence.
Rich and honorable lords, took over the dominance from the Romans. On black steeds and soldiers on foot were all loyal to their lords, eager to defend and fight. Their responsibility? Defending the territory from rivals and keeping the peasants in line. Frisian horses were valued as war horses for their strength and stamina. Their size enabled them to carry knights in heavy armor. Lords ruled the land. Farmers worked the fields as landowners in return for protection against enemies.
Every day, lords drove beautiful characters will be pulled by stunning Frisian horses. Noblemen and ladies preferred Frisian horses for their elegance and grandeur.
I'm not afraid of the dark.
for the gold and chapter closed. It's frozen chapter, and it's that in the start of the 20th century, the Frisian freedom was almost extinct. By that time, there were only 3 breeding stallions left. This caused those who were breeding Frisians to form an association and start a registry to protect the breed.
Of Narnia, featuring one of our favorite heroes,
prince Caspian himself, gallantly commanding his mighty Frisian steed. And of course, who could forget the wonderful Lucy and Susan? The narrative that has every child check the back of their linen closet to see what secrets and adventures it might hold for them, and whether or not they get to meet Aslan.
Thank you.
was all too eager to travel to Atlanta in 2013 to have his horses featured in blinged-out chariots with the moving blazing arrows in the parade of tributes.